Happy birthday, Cancer! Welcome to July. We are going to look at a main theme for the month, where you need to focus your energy, what your challenges are going to be, what it is you need to release. And challenges and what you need to release are going to be very important because we're coming into Mercury retrograde energy. We're going to look at money and career, just because on the Facebook page, that's what you guys voted for as your biggest interest for the month of July. And then we're going to look at your love life. So Cancer singles, couples, and undefined relationships, which could be on again, off again relationships. Maybe it's not Facebook official, or maybe it's polyamorous. Okay, so let's get started. Cancer, July, your theme for the month is satisfaction. It's like getting all of these things that you said you wanted. Now, for some of you, that's going to be like, oh shit, now what do I want next? Right? For some of you, it's just like, oh, awesome. Like, I'm finally here. I have what I desire. And so that's things that we want to focus on is what exactly do we want? Because in July, it just very well might be yours. The thing is that some of you might be focusing on kind of like boredom or what's going, not necessarily what's going wrong, but it's kind of like boredom or sadness from time to time. And they're saying, this is actually okay in the Mercury retrograde energy so long as you're framing it as a challenge. Like, okay, what do I need to do to overcome this? What is it that I need to address or look at to move forward and pass this to sort of purge this energy? Now, some of you might be standing there kind of going, oh, I don't know if this is worth it, but it shall be for you. So it's kind of like you take this rest of satisfaction. And okay, so I've already made it so far. Now this is the next hurdle. And then thinking about laying out a plan in order to get there. They say, some of you are probably going to be like right now, what the fuck is she talking about? And so as July progresses, you might want to come back and watch this video and see how it feels different for you. For a lot of you, it seems like it might be challenging this month because there's all of these thoughts that are kind of going in circles, like figure eights and kind of entangling upon each other. And so it's really, really hard to step back and see what it is that you need to be focused on and think about to have this clear-headed energy. The trick to getting there is actually going to be by talking it through with somebody else. And they're saying, reminding yourself that things are pretty okay and a lot better than, like they could be a lot worse, right? Things are actually for the most part really, really good for you right now if you're just to like think about it. And so it's like, okay, what could I do to make my life better? And talking this through with other people in your life, whether that's a sibling or a therapist, your tarot reader, doesn't matter. But this is how you're going to work that out. Because your thoughts are sort of entwining and it makes it really, really hard to sort of envision what is the next step and how to go attack dog to achieve all the things that you want and desire. You might not even know what you want just because everything's kind of interwoven in the month of July. And so they're saying be open to messages from the spirit world, whether that comes in the form of repeating numbers or songs that get stuck in your head or even advice or guidance from people that you care about or trust. So other challenges you might face this month, they're just saying like a lack of desire to sort of like take action and start new things. Now, typically in a Mercury retrograde, that's actually sort of a good thing. We don't want to start new things in a retrograde, but they're saying your activity level in general might be down for those of you who are too focused on what's going wrong as opposed to kind of stepping up to the challenge and trying to find the way out. They're saying you're going to get out of every situation what you put into it. And this is actually the case with your energy level as well. So the more that you do, the more energy you'll have. The more that you kind of rest and take time to sleep and, you know, whatever, the more tired you're actually going to be. So this month, that's just something to be sort of conscious of or aware of. You might want to just like kind of force yourself to up and start doing something, moving in one way or another so that you can achieve the things that maybe seem too hard on a daily basis. Now, in regards to, let's see, what you needed to release, they're saying a lot of you have like emotionally moved on from something and you're moving towards something, you're moving towards trying to achieve something that you care about even more. So it was something that you had like deep attachment to. That could be a relationship, it could be a job, it could just even be a mindset, a memory. But they're saying like once you decide to move on from that, there are huge rewards coming for you as a result. So trying to just kind of say, okay, that was really good for me in a certain period of my life, but now I want something greater or something more. And letting those things go, even though they're still special, will really, really pay off. What's up for you in money and career? They say this is the area where a lot of you aren't feeling necessarily massively enthused, but make sure that you're super open to receiving. So if somebody says, hey, let me pay you a little extra for the time that you gave me. Don't go, no, 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 not necessary. Say, okay, thank you. I really appreciate that. They're saying this is actually going to make you feel really good if you're able to do that. And by pushing away any sort of gift or reward, what you're doing is not only are you disservicing yourself by not accepting it, but you just denied somebody else an opportunity to feel good about themselves for their charity or their kindness and their way of showing love and appreciation. And so they're saying this is a choice that you could make, and it would actually make you feel a lot less stressed out and a lot more happy as long as you're open to those sorts of things. So that could be in the form of actual money. That could be in the form of compliments. Somebody says, hey, you look really cute today. And you go, oh, no, you look cute. Don't push away those compliments. Say, thank you. I really appreciate that kind of compliment. They feel good then for giving it, and you feel good because you took it. Same thing with help even. And sometimes we get in that mindset like, oh, I don't want other people to help me because they're going to do it wrong. But try really to challenge yourself to be open to allowing other people to help you, because that can pay off for you in your career and also in your finances. They're saying these sorts of energies, if you should embrace them, will really help you to feel a lot more joyous and loving towards your career. Feelings that maybe the month starts out like, I don't really want to go to work, I don't know. This is going to help you to feel better about that and completely flip that upside down. And they're saying even if you don't outwardly express that or show it, that's a big change that will be really, really beneficial for you. In regards to your love life, if you're a single Cancer, they're saying this is a very exciting and passionate month. This is a month where you could go on like fun dates and adventures with people. They're saying, and this is actually for your highest good. So if you're not in the mood to go out and like date, I would actually try to challenge myself to do that, because things could change very quickly for you in a very positive way this month. Lots of like lusty and fun social energy. And for some Cancers, like you might be kind of an introverted extrovert, or very introverted, but this won't be scary or awkward. It'll just be fun and joyous. So challenge yourself. Now, for those of you who are coupled, this is a month where there's something that you really need to say to your partner, and maybe you're afraid to do it. And it's not, you have the same end goal in mind. You both want to be together. You both want to achieve A, B, C, D, but you maybe have different ideas on how that should look. Maybe you want to live together at some point, but one of you thinks it should be after marriage. One of you thinks it should be beforehand. Or maybe you both want to get married, or you both want to be together, but one of you doesn't believe in marriage and the other does. And so there could be bickering and arguing about how to achieve those things. Focus on the end goal, and the end goal there is love and affection, okay? What is it that truly makes your heart sing? Not what other people think you should want, or what's like what society thinks you should want, or what you used to want. It's about what makes me really happy right now, and focus on that, because that makes your relationship a lot less work, a lot more easy, and a lot more joyful and fulfilling. For those of you who are in those undefined relationships I mentioned, they're saying watch out for lies and betrayal. And so they're saying it's maybe not something you're worried about, so you're like, oh, fuck, like where's this coming from? I'm gonna thumbs down this video. But as the month progresses, this is something that is actually maybe a reality for some of you. Now, you might get defensive and you might be like, oh, that's not going to happen to me. That's not my situation. She's totally wrong. But come back to this video at the end of the month and see where this might be right for you, because they're saying like, look, if you're the one who's maybe betraying somebody else or lying, they're saying like you're going to be on the defense. You're going to have to, you're going to get caught, and you're going to be on the defense. Now, if you're the one who's being lied to, they will be defensive, and they're not going to be honest about it straight out the gate, unless you confront them with proof, which is unfortunate that that kind of thing might happen. But ultimately, I feel like if that happens, if you're on the side of the relationship in which you feel lied to or betrayed, this wasn't the relationship for you anyway. And so don't let it like really, really get you down. Now, how many people is this message for? Because I can't believe that that would be everybody in an undefined relationship. And they say, it's actually for a lot of you, unfortunately. But this is a moment in time in which you get to heal, okay? That now what you get to do with this information is not only heal this current wound, but heal past wounds and then make changes so that you can avoid that stuff moving forward in different subsequent relationships. They're saying this will help you to allow love to flow into your life a little bit easier. They're saying, like, typically we'll put up a defense to prevent against those sorts of things, but we're never able to control what other people do or how they treat us, right? And so this is kind of teaching us what our own boundaries are and where we need to assert them and apply them and really care for ourselves first and foremost. So it's sort of like a lesson in self-love. So that's not an easy one, and I'm sorry. Hopefully August will be better, and I'll talk to you then. Thanks so much for watching this video and getting all the way to the end of it. I really appreciate your support. If you are interested in other videos, click here. If you are interested in subscribing, go ahead and click here. Hit that notification bell so that you get alerted to when new videos come out and also when I do surprise live streams. And then if you're interested in winning a free 20-minute video reading personally every month, go ahead and click right here. Mwah!